Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamu alaikum. This is Asad Yaqub.
Assalamu alaikum. This is Shumaila Najib.
And we are very polite people.
Yeah.
Because
yes,
whenever we sip coffee, we feel great, we feel excited. So I'm quite excited to be here.
And ye bhi bata dein kidhar hai?
At the moment we are in Bhurban, and this is a hotel here. It's Pearl Continental Hotel. They call it PC Bhurban. And Bhurban is in Murree. Murree is very close to Islamabad.
Mm-hmm.
Islamabad is the capital of Pakistan. And we are happy to be here.
Mm-hmm.
Actually, you know, the environment is good.
Very peaceful.
Peaceful. And
beautiful.
The location
yeah.
is quite nice, and ambiance is quite good as well. So we decided to talk to you.
Yes.
All right.
और कॉफ़ी का भी बताते हैं कितने मज़े की
कॉफ़ी इज गुड इट्स आइसक्रीम कॉफ़ी कोल्ड कॉफ़ी विद वनीला आइसक्रीम सो इट्स ऑसम नाउ वी नीड टू कम टू द पॉइंट
हाँ जी असद से मैं जो अभी पूछने लगी हूँ ना वो आइल्स रीडिंग से रिलेटेड क्वेश्चन है
ओके
ठीक है
नो वरीज
अच्छा अभी मैं सिंगल क्वेश्चन नहीं करूँगी मैं डायरेक्ट आपसे ये पूछूँगी आइल्स रीडिंग की टिप्स
Okay, I'm always willing to give the tips. So, I'll do one thing, one tip and one sip.
Okay, fine.
S-I-P, sip, T-I-P, tip. So, it's going to be sip tip.
हाँ जी,
yeah,
sip tip
we can
तो
call
हो
it sip tip.
ये ना वो आ जाएं जी हमारी tip.
हमारी tip का भी.
Tip.
But this is not that tip actually, okay? So, this is actually going to
actually,
be sip and tip.
Actually, we are talking about tip
ना, तो tip. That's right. So,
okay.
The tips which I'm going to give you right now, they are general IELTS reading
mm-hmm.
tips. And they are not specific academic or general training.
Mm-hmm.
These tips apply both modules, academic as well as general training. The first thing is, do not expect to understand every word which is given in the passage.
Okay.
You know, at times what happens, they give you certain words in the passage. And some words are very, very difficult. Some words are new. And there are, I'm sure, in reading, there are some words that you just come across these words first time in
first
your
time,
life.
Exactly.
In your life, actually, yes. So you come across these words first time in your life. That's why do not expect to understand every word. And by the way, without understanding every word, even then, you can easily do all the questions
acha sab is pe main ek aur cheez kahungi main kabhi books wagaira koi padh rahi hu na novel to usme kya hota hai motivational book padh rahi hu kai words aise aate hain jo aapko nahi sahi se meaning pata hota lekin aap understand kar jate ho through sentence
that's right we call it the contextual meaning of the word so you need to focus the contextual meaning of the word that in which context the word is actually used so you can see the part of speech of the word noun pronoun adverb and all that so you can understand so without understanding all the words still you can answer the questions properly
Great.
The first thing okay second practice your reading skills not just IELTS reading for God's sake I've noticed one thing many students they only practice IELTS reading they practice book after book test after test they don't know behind IELTS reading there is the reading skill Now, for instance, if I'm a regular reader, I read novels, I read magazines, I read different newspapers. So that is general reading.
Okay.
After reading this, if I do any IELTS reading test, I'll be comfortable with that. I can do it easily because I am good at general reading. So it's basically students only practice IELTS reading. They don't understand one thing that they have to practice reading in general. Okay, so this is another important thing that you should, I mean, I usually recommend this to the students to subscribe local newspaper, English newspaper actually, right? To read magazines once a month or twice a month, you can subscribe the magazines. Then you can read some articles, features, and read only the stuff which is somewhat like IELTS reading.
हाँ जी क्योंकि ये तो हमें पता है ना कि किस टाइप के टॉपिक्स आते हैं जनरल आइल्स में एंड एकेडमिक
एक्जैक्टली सो फॉर एग्जांपल इफ यू आर एकेडमिक आइल्स कैंडिडेट यू नीड टू रीड आर्टिकल्स व्हिच आर बेस्ड ऑन साइंस
टेक्नोलॉजी
रिसर्च इनोवेशन न्यू इन्वेंशंस ऑफ साइंस रोबोटिक्स राइट डिजीजेस So these type of things you can read. If you're general training, then you can read certain brochures, articles, and all that. So this is my tip number two.
अच्छा सर, इस पे एक question मेरा ये भी है कि जैसे आपने कहा कि reading जो है आप करनी चाहिए तो ये तो वो तो आपका ख्याल है reading को हमारे हमें अपनी habit बना लेना चाहिए
देखें एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर डूइंग आयल्स राइट यू शुड मेक इट अ हैबिट अडॉप्ट इट एज अ टेम्पररी हैबिट यू नो देयर आर टू टाइप ऑफ हैबिट्स वन इज परमानेंट वन इज टेम्पररी सो एज लॉन्ग एज यू आर डूइंग आयल्स I mean, it is around a tenure of 3 months, for 6 months, or for 1 year when you are doing IELTS. So sometimes it's 3 months, you get your required band after 3 months. Sometimes it's 6 months. Some students say, I've got 1 year to do my IELTS. So as long as you are doing IELTS, you need to make it your habit. It should be, reading should be your habit. And again, I tell you, what you read is very important. It's just not that you are reading horror novels. And you are expecting to get good band score in IELTS, that's what Shumaila reads, okay? It's not that you're reading just, children books, right? Child books, and then you expect to get good band. No, you got to see whatever you read, it should be matched. We'll make a separate video. I'm going to recommend some magazines where they can get good band score. There are certain magazines. So this is important. Now, we move on to our tip number 3, and that is, read the instructions very carefully. Sometimes students do not read the instructions carefully. What they do, they just do the questions, right? And they start, okay, this is true, false, not given. I've noticed, Shumaila, this test, I received around 4-5 messages and the students complained, not complained, they did a mistake in their exam. They said, sir, instead of true, false, not given, I wrote yes, no. So actually you had to write true or false, and the students, they wrote yes, no. Why? Because they don't read carefully. Sometimes the question type is no more than 2 words and students write 3 words. Sometimes it's no more than 1 word and students write 2 words. So that's why another important thing is you need to read and follow the instructions very, very carefully.
Sir, if we don't follow the instructions, then you can't do your answers correctly.
Most definitely.
You also said yes, no, likha, true, false, not given ka tha question. This is the same thing. I have a message that I have to do. What do I
do? That's right.
Now, I don't understand. Now, what do we do if we don't do anything? Now, what will happen?
That will happen. So, tip number 4 is don't panic. Many students are afraid of reading and they're afraid of reading actually they are afraid because when they see difficult words, when they see big words, right, they don't know, they come across such words for the first time in their life, so they don't know, so they are panic about it. So don't panic, just relax, okay? There are new words. As I said, don't expect to understand every word. So you don't need to panic about that. Okay, there is another important thing. That is my tip number 5. That IELTS reading is rarely a vocabulary test. It is a vocabulary test, no doubt. You know, that's why they see synonyms are there. A lot of paraphrasing is there. Synonyms, paraphrasing, this, that, and all that. So it's basically a vocabulary test. That's why I would advise you all to improve your vocabulary, number one. Number two, you have to expand your reading. There should be some extensive reading practice or extensive reading you got to do, because you should be able to understand new words, you should be able to understand difficult words, and the most important thing is actually paraphrasing of the words. So that is another tip. Shall we go on?
Yeah, please. लेकिन पहले एक सिप ले ली
ओके
वरना आप लोगों ने कहना है कि असद ने सिर्फ हमें दिखाने के लिए रखी हुई है कॉफी इन्हीं की है
ओके नाउ द नेक्स्ट थिंग इज टाइमिंग इज क्रूशियल व्हेनेवर यू टेक आईएलटीएस टेस्ट टाइमिंग इज वेरी वेरी क्रूशियल आई हैव नोटिस्ड स्टूडेंट्स दे सॉल्व द टेस्ट एंड दे डोंट टेक केयर अबाउट टाइम So instead of solving the test in 1 hour, they solve the test in 3 hours, 2 hours, and then they practice like this. And then when they go to actual test, they have only 1 hour. And another thing, students, when they practice, they never transfer the answers to the answer sheet. That's why when they go to take their real test, they have to transfer the answers to the answer sheet as well. That takes time as well. So all these things, when they get together, for students, it becomes difficult to attempt the test. I have noticed many students, they only attempt first 2 sections or maximum 2.5 sections, and then the time runs out. And I have noticed some students, they fail to transfer the answers to the answer sheet as well.
But this means that you haven't done anything if you haven't transferred it.
Most definitely, most definitely. So Shumaila, I think it's a good idea that we are keeping this video bilingual.
Yes, I have told you before that we should do this so that those who have a little problem in Urdu,
At least those who can't understand Urdu Hindi, they can understand English.
अच्छा सर मुझे इसी पे याद आया कि जैसे आपने कहा ना ट्रांसफर कर, आप थोड़ा सा ये भी बताना कि इसको ट्रांसफर हमें साथ साथ कर लेना चाहिए प्रैक्टिस करते हुए.
दैट्स गुड. सो एज फार एज ट्रांसफरिंग द आंसर क्वेश्चंस टू द आंसर्स टू द आंसर शीट इज कंसर्न, इट्स अ गुड आइडिया. व्हेन यू डू सेक्शन वन, ट्रांसफर योर आंसर्स टू द आंसर शीट. देन यू डू सेक्शन टू, ट्रांसफर योर आंसर्स टू द आंसर शीट. एंड सेक्शन थ्री, हियर इज द क्वेश्चन बुकलेट, राइट द आंसर्स डायरेक्टली टू द आंसर शीट, बिकॉज एट द एंड यू डोंट हैव इनफ टाइम.
और ऐसा एक और चीज़, जिस तरह आप टाइम का इसमें बता रहे हैं रीडिंग में मैनेज करने का, तो ऐसे मेरे जहन में ये आ रहा था कि जब ये लोग प्रैक्टिस करें, जाहिर बात है प्रैक्टिस करेंगे तो टाइम मैनेज होगा ना, देन उसमें अपनी शीट पर ट्रांसफर करने के आंसर ट्रांसफर करने का भी टाइम बीच में
एडजस्ट करें.
ये होता है, पता है कि ये लोग प्रैक्टिस करते हैं, वन आवर का रखते हैं टाइम जी, इसमें हमने टेस्ट कर लिया, बाकी थोड़ा टाइम
चाहिए. The tip number 7 is ignore anything you already know about the topic. Ignore that. Okay. I mean, for example, if they give you a topic, they give you an article, and you know, you say, I know a lot about it. Remember one thing, you only have to answer on the basis of the information they have given you in the passage. Not any extra information. There are noisy kids all around, huh? Okay, so you don't have to do it with the, like, you know, you say, I know everything. I give you one good example. If they say Washington is the capital of America, right? Now everybody knows that. There is a question in true, false, not given. Washington is the capital of America. But in the passage, it's not mentioned. Question is, Washington is the capital of America, but in passage, it's not mentioned. So answer is not going to be true. Answer is not going to be false. It's not given.
Not given.
Now you say, I know Washington is the capital of America. Everybody knows. It's not what you already know, what everybody already knows. So it's important to see that you don't guess on the basis of your general knowledge. That's not good. Next. Tip number 9, be extra careful when transferring the answers to your answer sheet. Sometimes, you know what happens? What do the students do? They're transferring the answer. Suddenly, question number is 5. They write it on answer sheet number 6. Question number 6, they shift it on answer sheet number 7. Yeah. This is dangerous, quite dangerous. So they just do it like that. And then at the end, when they reach question number 40 on the answer sheet, that's 39. And then they realize, oh my God. I mean, then every answer will be considered wrong. If there is any mistake like that, then every answer will be considered wrong. So be extra careful. Question number 1, answer on answer sheet box number 1. Question number 2, answer on answer sheet box number 2. And it should go on like that.
और असद अगर हम थोड़ा सा ये भी टाइम रखें कि इसको रीचेक कर लें कि हमने
सही That's a good idea. That's a very good idea. And at the end, the last tip is do not leave any blanks. Guess. I mean, whatever the question type is, if it is true, false, not given, or it is yes, no, not given, you can always guess. Even if it is like sentence completion, you can always guess, right? So I would say do not leave any blank, just guess. And by the way, if the time is running out, you are left with 10 minutes, so then again, you can guess more, and this is how you can finish your question.
क्योंकि ऐसा negative marking तो है नहीं.
There isn't any negative marking, so you can, but that doesn't mean just guess. I've noticed some students, they only guess, they don't do anything else. So guys, be careful, these are just 10 tips. And these tips will help you with IELTS reading. If you like this video, hit the like button and don't forget to subscribe my channel. I run another channel, Asad Yaqub Vlogs. You can subscribe to that as well. And I do have a Facebook page, Asad Yaqub IELTS. You must subscribe my, you must like my Facebook page. Thank you very much. I teach IELTS online. If you want to join my online arts classes, my WhatsApp number is given. You can contact me for that. Asad Yaqub and
From Ireland,
wish you all the best. Take care. Allah Hafiz.